Hello ladies, gentlemen and unicorns, welcome to another little educational video about visual effects in games. Today I thought we'd talk a little about lens flares. What they are, what causes them, what elements they are made up of, and maybe we look at some basic implementations of how to do this in your game. So without further ado, let's get started. What we commonly know as lens flare is an optical artifact or multiple optical artifacts caused by reflections and scattering of intense light sources inside a photographic lens. When I say lens flare, you're probably not thinking so much of this, but of this. Or maybe this. While our eyes are made up of a single lens, camera optics, such as this is a zoom lens, are made up of multiple lens elements. If you have watched my previous video on chromatic aberration, you might be familiar with this diagram of a lens. In principle, it works like this. Light rays enter the lens on the front and are bent or refracted so that they appear sharp or focused as a so-called real image here. This is where the image sensor of a camera resides, or the gate with the film negative in an analog camera. But photographic lenses of today don't look as simple as this, they look more like this. This complexity allows, for example, adjusting the focus and also produces sharper images with less unwanted artifacts. Especially zoom lenses are very complex and consist of many different movable lens groups or lens elements. Just for clarification, when I'm talking about the lens elements, I'm referring to these individual bits and pieces here. When I say lens, I mean the whole thing from front to back, not just a single lens element.
Alright, but what happens now when light enters the lens?
With each lens element a light ray travels through, it gets bent ever so slightly when it transitions from lens to air. It's like a stick in a glass of water appears bent because the water, and the glass for that matter, have a different refractive index than air. So the light passes through different media all the time. Air, glass, air, and each lens element has a different refractive index. But with each transition to a new medium, a very small portion of the light doesn't pass through the array of lens elements as intended. Instead, it gets reflected and bounces around before hitting the focal plane, causing artifacts. This refracting is minimized by lens manufacturers with all sorts of anti-reflective coating, but it's impossible to get rid of entirely. Thankfully, in scenes with largely uniform light intensities, this is negligible. These stray light rays have such a small intensity that they don't affect the picture noticeably. But what if a light is now magnitudes brighter than everything else? At once, all this unintended diffracting and bouncing between the lens elements inside a lens becomes clearly visible on the film plane and is, you guessed it, what we know as lens flare.
So now that we know what causes lens flares, what do they look like? Yeah, of course. I mean, what makes them appear the way they do?
In fact, a lot of characteristics are defined by the aperture in the lens. So let's have a look at this before moving on. The aperture is made up of a circular array of blades inside the lens, 5, 8 blades, 9, depending on the lens type or manufacturer. The shape of its opening defines the appearance of what's called a circle of confusion, and incidentally also the appearance of lens flare artifacts. What we call lens flare is the sum of different optical phenomena defined by how much and how often a light gets bounced and reflected inside the lens. An intense light without any bounces is called a starburst, and it gets its star shape from the diffraction at the aperture that sits inside the lens. The number of points this star has is defined by the number of blades in the aperture. The smaller the aperture is,
the pointier the star will become. The more the aperture is opened, the more it will look like a glow with just some spikes. Right, there's also the simple glow, caused by the roughness of the first lens or dust on it, but it could also be caused by backscattering on the focal plane, but that's a whole different story. Then, those big colored blobs that appear seemingly at random are called ghosts. They are reflections of the strong light inside the lens that just bounced around a bit. Their silhouette is defined by the shape of the aperture. So a five-bladed aperture produces only pentagon-shaped ghosts, for example. Simply speaking, the more lens elements there are in a lens, the more ghosts it will produce, and the smaller the aperture is, the smaller these ghosts appear. Compare here a flare in a zoom lens with a flare in a fixed focal length lens. And finally, we have those iconic streaks. You see them in a lot of the big sci-fi films, for example. This kind of artifact originates from the use of anamorphic lenses, lenses that optically squeeze the image horizontally to make it possible to fit a picture that's twice as wide onto a standard 35mm motion picture film frame. These lenses are terribly expensive, and their odd squashing capability facilitates all sorts of strange optical artifacts, not just streaks, but also chroma rings or oval bokeh circles.
Wow, yeah, that was a lot of theoretical background for you to chew on, so I think we can leave it at that for today. Next time I thought we'd look more into the practical side of things. How to construct a fitting lens flare that looks realistic for your game. And we might even look into the nitty-gritty of principles of implementing them in Unity and Game Maker. So until then, may the overly intense light be with you. Okay, it's getting a bit strong now. Okay, it's you. Too strong.